Chinese city of Wuhan and nearby towns locked down.
This time the outbreak is in Beijing.
There is new concern over the spread of COVID-19.
New cases of COVID-19 are surging.
COVID-19 is now the third leading cause of death in the U.S.
They're fighting a war here and they're losing.
Could there be a cause for concern for all of us?
For those of you with specialized skills looking to help our frontline workers, we do want to hear from you.
At the onset of the COVID-19 pandemic in March, McMaster Engineers came together acting swiftly and pivoted their research to tackle challenges related to the pandemic. They answered the call from the federal government to create solutions to a shortage of personal protective equipment. They started designing and testing mask prototypes that could be made locally. Soon, more members of our firewall family joined the fight. Amanda Tompkins, electrical and biomedical engineering student, and her sister Kayla, a nursing student, designed a mask that could be used in place of an N95 respirator. Engineering student Alec Fernbeck and his father and professor Michael Noseworthy produced 3D printed face shields in the iBiomed design studio. Longin Vision, a McMaster Engineering startup, created Gatekeeper, a temperature sensing technology that can be used in public places to detect a high body temperature, a common symptom of COVID-19. In June, McMaster opened the Center of Excellence in Protective Equipment and Materials. The center is dedicated to the advancement of personal protective equipment products in Canada. Ishwar K. Puri, Dean of Engineering, and his team created a 15-minute test that can detect SARS-CoV-2 antibodies in blood with a finger prick. As the world waits for an effective vaccine to COVID-19, our researchers are bringing to market a technology to store and transport vaccines safely without refrigeration. McMaster researchers, students, and industry partners continue to work together to face unprecedented challenges caused by COVID-19. Our innovative efforts will make a difference in our communities in the months and years to come.